episode 1846, Simplicity is Golden.
Moms, needing a little inspiration and a ray of hope? You've come to the right place. This is the show that you can turn to for just the pick-me-up you need. This is Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop
sign, watching people drive. Happy, happy day. You are almost there. Yes, it is Thursday, which means it's Inspiration Motivation Day. Take a deep breath. I don't know about you, but this week seems extra long. Yes, it's the last week of January, but you can do it. Simplicity is golden. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple strategy, everyday solutions to live, love, and impact. Well, why do you complicate life so often with overwhelm and busyness flooding your schedule? Don't waste another moment. Simplicity is golden. The badge of honor that everyone seems to covet is that of busyness, outdoing your neighbor and overplaying your best friend. But where does that get you in life? For most, it causes a deep divide in the family, whether it be between spouses, children and a parent, even the pets feel a little out of sorts. The greater the divide, the deeper the wound. Yet you keep on pushing, trying to gain more momentum when all your body can do is barely make it to the pillow. If only pause was inserted into your everyday, how would that impact your day differently? Yesterday for me was just jam-packed. I had multiple commitments that required travel all over town, followed by chauffeuring the children to and from their schools and their activities. I hoped the day would slow down, but it was off to the races from the very beginning. And by the time I was coming home for dinner, I had still two conference calls left and my evening class. Whew. That doesn't put in there going to the bathroom, maybe eating a few snacks at least, you know, taking a shower, exercise, maybe picking up the mail. I think I went to the post office too. All in all, I don't think I had any private time except in the restroom. I know, TMI, we won't go there, but believe it or not, my day actually ran very smoothly. If I was only to tell you the schedule, you may look at it and go, my gosh, Christiane, there's no way that you could have packed all that in there. The thing was, is I was able to get everything done and get to bed even before the stroke of midnight. Simplicity is golden. My day was full, but not overcrowded. I knew exactly what I could do in the period of time allotted. I didn't stress and remained engaged throughout my day. However, most of us spread ourselves way, way, way too thin. The busier we claim, the more accomplished we feel. Or do we? Is it merely for the enjoyment of one-upmanship? It might be hard to change your schedule, but you don't want to go to the doctor's and have the doctor change your schedule. So many times we find ourselves waiting for a crisis to slow down, to press pause. And that crisis may come from an accident, an incident at school with the kids. It could come from a loved one getting sick, or it may come from your personal health and well-being. But why do we wait for a crisis? Why do we have to wait for a shakeup? Simplicity is golden. I want you to look at your schedule tomorrow and over the next few days. I know you probably can't change much today. So look at it for tomorrow and the next few days, even into the next few weeks, but just start here, very small. What can you give up or delegate in order to gain a more succinct schedule? I know for me, when my children were much, much smaller, and I have no idea why I did this, honestly. I mean, I am a very high energy person. I love it. When I come and I chat with you every single day, I'm telling you, most of the time, I'm on fire, and hopefully you can feel that. It's my heart. I love what I do. I love serving people, and it's just part of my life. It's been that way since I was, well, I can't remember. Like literally as far back as I can remember. And my mom would tell me, yeah, that's exactly how you came out. You just had this zest for life. You loved people. You were always engaged in everybody, what they were doing. You always gave the extra. And so when we were married and having children and they were so young and I was homeschooling, for some reason, I thought I could still do it all. I could have it all put together. My house clean and orderly, the kids disciplined, well loved, well taken care of, the husband in love with me even more than when he first met me. And it worked for a little while. I volunteered out in the community. I was very, very engaged in my church. Started programs left and right. Built things from scratch. Built a business. Was an entrepreneur. All of this stuff, right? And I thought, I can do it all. Until at various points in my life, I got these red flags. And the red flags were, slow down. Pause. Oh, no, but for me, I just chalked it up to, oh, I've been working too hard. So it's just my little breakdown moment. My body just needs some healing. Give me a couple days and I'll be right back at it. And that's what I did. And for a period of a few years, it worked. I would go real hard at something. And then next thing you know, I'd crash for a few days. And then I'd go real hard at something and I'd crash. It was this constant roller coaster, year after year, this up and down. Little did I know, God was trying to tell me, hello, you're not doing what I created you to do. You're doing too much. You need to slow down. So at one point, he slowed me down. He literally took my health from me. I was in the middle of a major volunteer series at church with Praise Kids, and I became sick. I couldn't do the camp. It was a solid week or 2 weeks. Now I forget. It's been so long. That means I'm getting older, but that's okay, right? It was a long period of time, and my team had to take over. It wasn't about me because I didn't have what it took. Except when I finally was able to have enough strength, I came back and was there for the performance. Because that's all I could do. I couldn't do anything else. I didn't have the strength. Why is it that we let a crisis come into our life before we realize that maybe we need to slow down? Maybe we need that pause. Commit to that which matters most. Look at your season and focus on your priorities. Don't flounder trying to do it all. It only buries you quicker. Cherish what brings you joy. Celebrate the freedom to do what you love. Complete the responsibilities with a smile on your face. Life is too short to stuff your days with things that don't matter to you. Be present in your everyday. Be incredible in your planning. Be you, because there is no one like you. Simplicity is golden. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a glorious, beautiful day. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.